Denver.
So we're in Denver for the weekend. It is October 21st today, Saturday. We came in late last night. We went to a haunted house here, and we'll show you a few footage of that. And tonight we are going to the Shiny Ball, which is the whole reason that we came here, because we've been wanting to do this for years, to go to the Stanley Hotel that throws that every year. So we're super excited. We're just taking in some sights today. So we'll show you a little bit of what Denver has to offer.
So first things first, brunch. A friend recommended we try Happy Camper, and we had one of the best brunch experiences. First off, they offer you a complimentary glass of champagne, and of course we were in love with all of the funky decor and all the disco balls. We got the breakfast za pizza, breakfast tacos, and their hangover iced coffee, which ironically did have alcohol in it. Everything was so delicious, although my mom wasn't the biggest fan of the coffee.
It's so hot.
Do they call it a streakeasy bar? That's what it's
called. If you find yourself in Denver and you're looking for a good time, a cute brunch spot, and some good food and drinks, I highly recommend coming to the Happy Camper. My favorite part of exploring Denver was just admiring all of the fall leaves. Seriously, so gorgeous. For our next stop, we went to Little Man Ice Cream, also recommended by another friend of mine, and we got the pumpkin chocolate chip ice cream, and it was really good. We also just loved how into Halloween this ice cream shop was and admired all the spooky decorations. From there, we explored a little bit more of the downtown and found this little area called the Dairy Block that had all these pumpkins, and we just thought the whole alleyway was just so cute, and it was giving us all the fall feels. And then lastly, we stopped at Larimer Square. So we had to rush back to the hotel so that we could quickly get ready for the Shining Ball, which was over an hour away from downtown Denver. For our costumes, we decided to all go as 1920s dead flappers.
Either you're mine or you're not. Make up your mind, sweet baby.
This is so wrong. That hurts. That hurts. Okay, well, that's gonna be down enough, or is it gonna like stick out? It's supposed to go up on your back right now. You need a bunny butt is gonna be a problem.
Not on your head.
Put it on my head.
Oh my.
I have the word like a six head.
All ready for the Shining Ball.
So now we have officially made it to the Stanley Hotel, in which, if you didn't already know, the Stanley Hotel is what inspired Stephen King's book, The Shining. This is not the hotel that was in the movie. In the movie, the hotel was filmed on set and they used the outside of a different hotel, which in fact upset Stephen King so much that he wrote and produced The Shining miniseries in 1997, in which the miniseries was filmed at the Stanley Hotel.
Most folks who shine, only shine a little.
Another fun fact, they filmed Dumb and Dumber at this hotel.
There you go.
Before I get into the good stuff about Stephen King's stay here, I do want to quickly mention that Jim Carrey also stayed at the Stanley Hotel while filming Dumb and Dumber. Well, technically, he didn't even make it through the night. He stayed in the same haunted room that Stephen King stayed in and lasted only 3 hours inside before he came running outside of his room, outside of the hotel, in his boxers, screaming and demanding he stay somewhere else. To this day, Jim Carrey has still not spoke about what he experienced or what spooked him so badly.
10 out of 10?
10 out of 10.
What's this one called?
Red Rum. Red Punch.
I love the impression.
It's good. It's a little strong. What is it?
It's rum and blue. How do you pronounce that, Erica?
What's it called?
It's something, I don't know. Blue Colorado.
Should've got the red one.
We got to the Stanley Hotel early so that we could explore the property, and we also had made dinner reservations. The restaurant was so nice and fancy, and the food was amazing. We got the meatloaf, and the mashed potatoes were so dang good that we ordered an extra side of them. And then for dessert, we got the monkey bread. The restaurant also had all these framed pictures of famous people that have stayed at the hotel, which included Stephen King, of course, Jeff Daniels and Jim Carrey from Dumb and Dumber, Johnny Cash, Bob Dylan, and even Pink.
Jim Carrey also stayed here, and it scared the bejesus out of him. And we'll tell you more about that story a little bit later. This room is almost impossible to get booked, or we would have booked it.
Super haunted.
This room is what inspired the entire movie of The Shining, the novel, everything.
I'm gonna axe this door.
Like, literally tried to axe it down. Do you see that?
So now we are finally exploring the halls of the Stanley Hotel, and scary enough, there was apparently a seance happening and we had to be quiet to not disturb them. We were searching for room 217, which we found, which is also the suite that Stephen King stayed in. He and his wife stayed the night at the Stanley Hotel in 1974. When they came to the hotel, they were the only guests at the hotel due to the slow winter season, and it gave a very eerie feeling. On this night, Stephen King had a nightmare that his 3-year-old son was running through the corridors screaming and was chased by a fire hose. Stephen King almost fell out of his bed and woke up sweating. Awaking from this dream, he lit a cigarette, sat down, and by the time the cigarette was done, he already had the entire idea for The Shining book. I find it absolutely amazing that in one night, Stephen King gathered the entirety of what The Shining novel would entail, all because of this dream that spooked the crap out of him, and that is why the Stanley Hotel takes pride in being the inspiration for Stephen King's book, and they host an annual Shining Halloween ball that we are so happy that we got tickets to, because this event usually sells out every year.
We are in the maze, which is a replica, little tiny replica, of what was in the movie, because if you know, the movie The Shining was not filmed here, but it was inspired by this hotel. Later, the series that Stephen King made was filmed at this hotel, so it's cool that they have the maze in here. But in the movie, the maze is, I mean, it's so much higher, so you can't find your way out. And when we came in February, I'll have a little bit of footage put in there of that. It was much spookier because it actually was snowing and it was freezing, and I came through the maze and I gave up after, like, I don't know, one row. I was like, I'm done.
Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got.
And now for the really fun part, the Shining Ball. We love the effort that they put into this event. They seriously did such a good job. Upon check-in, everyone gets 2 drink vouchers, a Shining-themed koozie, and a coin that had Jack Torrance's axe on one side with 217 on it, and the other side has the Stanley Hotel. They also had a Shining photo op as well as a fortune teller, and I really liked how the downstairs bar had a statue of Jack Nicholson's face from the movie. Okay, so while we were really enjoying the event, I do have to say that I felt the DJ could have been playing some better music. However, my mom was finally having a blast when they started to play Separate Ways by Journey. Truly an 80s girly. It was really fun getting to see everyone's unique costumes, and of course we enjoyed running into all the very many Jack Torrances and Shining Twins of the night. And actually, we dressed up as the characters from The Shining for Midsummer Scream in 2022, and we had so much fun doing that. If you're interested, we have another vlog on our channel all about it. While we didn't get entered into the costume contest, we were so happy to see Danny and Jack Torrance win the costume contest. They did such a good job, and overall we just had such a good time and so much fun at this event, and we just danced the night away. God damn.